When I find a bug that's marked as informative or just low severity, I don't skip it. I stop everything because if something seems useless, I need to understand why. Why it is low? Can I break it, chain it? Can I turn it into something real? That's how I have turned boring reports into highs and criticals. And CORS misconfigurations, they are the perfect examples. Everyone either ignores them or worse, reports them as is and gets slapped with not applicable. But on platforms like Yes We Hack, it is clear. CORS alone won't save you. It's in the non-qualifying list. But CORS with impact? That's a different story. In this video, we are going to dig into how real CORS bugs happened. I will show you how a misconfigured header on WordPress can leak an admin's entire profile. I will show you how I broke a Ruby-based app and got names, emails, session tokens, and even encryption keys, all through a low bug. And yeah, I will even show you how to scan for misconfigs in seconds using tools like CORS. And recently, Kaidu dropped a scanner plugin that checks for multiple issues, including CORS. It's slick, it's fast, and it helps you to find what everyone else is skipping. So, this is AmrSec, go get your coffee ready, and let's dive in. You know what most people do when they see a CORS misconfig? They ignore it or report it as is. And that's exactly why you should care. Because when everyone skips something, the right eyes turn it into a critical. So let's talk about the real misconfigurations, the ones that matter. Let's start with the most misunderstood one, the wildcard disaster. Access control allow origin star. Most people see that and think it's a jackpot. But here's the deal. If the response does not contain any sensitive data, it means nothing. Now it becomes dangerous when the response includes user data such as tokens or anything protected, or when the server stupidly adds access control allow credentials true. That combo is against spec, but some setups still do it. And when they do, it means any site can send a request and get privileged user data, including cookies. It's rare, but when it happens, it's usually game over. Second one is the reflection trap. This one's dangerous because it looks legit, but it's lying to you. You send an origin header with https://attacker.com and the response says access control allow origin https://attacker.com and access control allow credential true. That's not just a misconfig, that's a blind trust, and it gets worse if the response gets cached. What the server's doing is taking whatever origin you send after they reflecting it back in the response and literally saying, sure, here is the data, even if you are not the real site. If the user logged in and your attacker site makes the request behind the scene, you now get the authenticated response straight to your browser. But here is where things really go nuclear. If the response is cached, especially by a misconfigured CDN, you could poison the cache with your attacker controlled origin. Now every user, even those browsing directly, gets a response with your access control allow origin header. That means even if the user visits the real site, they are served your poisoned header. And if any of those responsive expose sensitive data, it's a full-blown CORS cache poisoning exploit. So yeah, reflection is bad, but reflection plus caching, that's weaponizable. So let's talk real world, the WordPress API trap. All the WordPress installs have this endpoint, /wp.json/wp/users. It leaks public users. Fine, informative. But there is /wp.json/wp/users/me. If the user is logged in, that leaks their full profile, email, name, role, sometimes even token details. And now guess what? If the site reflects origin and allows credentials, you just got a fully authenticated API response from your own malicious website. That's impact. So let me show you how this works. Okay, so basically, as you can see right here, I'm running a Docker container that runs the WordPress CORS misconfigured app. And if I go to my browser right here, you will see that I have logged in to WordPress using my username or email, which is the admin of this WordPress site. And basically, the site is misconfigured. So let me show you how the proof of concept looks like. So right here in Visual Studio Code, I have this file called index.wb.html, which basically have some basic HTML data. Like, all of this is just like titles and the styles. And the most important thing right here is the script. So the script right here basically just gets the data from /wb.json/wb/version2/users. And also there is other endpoint that gets all the data from wb.json. So basically right here, if I go back to my browser and go to this tab, I refresh, you will see that it is running on different port. So basically this is not running on the Docker container. It's just live reviewing from my Visual Studio Code. Okay. So basically if I just come right here and inspect the page, so I can open the network tab and let me reload the page. As you can see, if I just click still WB users, what I will get is all the users data for the misconfigured WordPress application. And that's actually it, because right now if I go to the network, as you can see, there is no problem with it. Like, it's not giving me CORS policy block this or something like this. So that's it. And it's still WB. So basically this is not settings, it's supposed to be wb.json. And right here it's giving me all the wb.json, which have all the endpoints, posts and everything. So right now we don't have any problem with the CORS. So if we just targeted another endpoints, like sensitive endpoints such as /users/me or whatever, and we just made this script runs automatically and send the data to our server, that's a complete exploit. Another real world example is Ruby sites. I have found this one while digging into a Ruby based target. I forced a JSON error on a .json endpoint, and the response was a beautiful JSON blob with my full name, phone number, email address, session token, encryption key, and a lot of more things, wrapped in an error message inside script tag. So why was it vulnerable? Because the site was CORS misconfigured and it allowed cross origin requests with credentials. So you visit my malicious site while logged in and boom, I grabbed your full profile from the broken API silently. So let me also show you an example. Okay, so right here, I'm also having the Ruby app running on the same Docker container. And if I go to my browser right here and refresh, you will see a beautiful page which shows the blog posts. And here are just take blog posts. And what I found on the target that I'm working on, something exactly like this, but it was a little bit huge. So it was the same things right here. So when I tried to add at the end of the URL.json, what I got is the JSON data for what I just saw rendered. So I was like, okay, and I want to try to let it like give me an error, to force an error. So I tried to do something like this and hit enter. And instead of giving me error like this, it's gave me error like this one. And right here, as you can see in this error, it's a little bit, you know, like it's a little bit weird, because as you can see right here, it have error JSON parser failed, and this exactly the error that I got. But after all of this, we have the current user, which is the ID here and the full name and the phone number and the email and the role, session token and encryption key. Actually, the profile was having a lot of other info, even the identity was here. So all of this was only showing by a small error. And the awesome thing that this website also was CORS misconfigured. So that means I can't just get these data for any user. I literally have all the user data. So we have also another proof of concept for this, which is on my Visual Studio Code. And right here, as you can see, it's index.ruby. So right here, it's also the same. All these things are just like styles and so on. But let me focus right here. You will see it is the same. Just going right here and go into boom.json, which is an example for the error endpoint. So if I just get back to my browser right here and go to the BOC and refresh, everything is fine. Cool. So let me just open the inspection for this and go to the network tab. So right here, if I try to click stealrobby.profile.json, it will give me this HTML thing. And if you take a look on the network tab, you will see that the profile.json is 404. Okay, good. But the problem is, like, it is still giving me 404. That means it's accepting the request. So if I click trigger Robby error dump, which it calls the boom.json file, as you can see right here, it just worked without any problem. It's giving me 500 internal server error because it is error. Okay, but at the same time, it's giving me the current user data, such as the ID, the full name, and the phone number. So it is the same. What we have to do is just create an HTML file that gets this data automatically or auto-submitting the form once it loads and just send it to your victim. Okay, by doing this, you will have a lot of data from a lot of users, and this will be a complete exploit. So yeah, that's pretty much it also. Now let's talk about how to catch the CORS misconfigs fast. If you want to scan for misconfigs, use CORS. It's a Python-based tool that built for this. It will detect wildcard origins, credentials issues, and severity levels fast. So to install CORS, what you have to do is search Google for CORS or just go to github.com/thisusername/CORS and scroll a little bit down, and to install it, just simple. Just get clone this repository into your machine, and what you have to do is change directory to it. After this, pipe 3 install-r requirements.txt so you can install the requirements of the tool. After this, it just installed with you. What you have to do is to understand the usage. So if you want to scan for one URL to use Python 3, corsi.py, and tag you that's telling corsi to scan for one URL. But if you have a list of URLs, what you have to do is to do the same, but just change the tag you with tag I, and after this, specify the path of URL's file. And now, Kaidu just released a scanner plugin. It checks for CORS, time-based SQL injection, and OpenRedirect, and more. Fire it up, check response headers, and see what others missed. So, CORS misconfig alone, it's setting, not a bug. But CORS misconfig plus context, that's a report. Look at YesWeHack, for example. If you just report misconfigured CORS, it's non-qualifying. But if you show that you leaked decisions info or performed authenticated action, now it's a high or even critical. The difference is impact, always. So next time you see a CORS misconfig and think, it's informative, think again. Dig, chain, break things. That's where the real bugs live. So I hope this video changed the way you look at CORS. Most hunters ignore it, some report it, but the ones who dig deep, they rewrite the game. And yeah, it's me. I don't report low severity, I rewrite them. So if you found this video helpful, do not forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon for more cybersecurity content. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the comments below, or you can reach me directly on Twitter. Until next time, stay curious and stay secure.